yet more disturbing pictures from Syria, most too upsetting to show. These are amongst 55,000 images smuggled out of the country showing systematic torture and murder by the government. It has been compared to what happened in early Nazi Germany. I believe the time has come to discuss military intervention in Syria. Not only has the bloodshed gotten worse and has the potential to get far worse, but the conflict is spreading elsewhere. The two main arguments against intervention are that we could aggravate the situation or that it's their mess and we shouldn't get involved. But both arguments are now redundant. The Syrian rebels are being forced out by Al-Qaeda groups who aren't interested in freedom, but to establish a permanent base in Syria away from the drones and soldiers in Afghanistan. They want a caliphate, a Sharia state, in both Syria and Iraq before other Middle Eastern countries are absorbed. If they gain the upper hand, they will use that new base to launch audacious attacks on surrounding countries and the West. Meanwhile, the humanitarian crisis gets worse every day. Over 100,000 people have died since this conflict began, and nearly 10 million people have been driven away from their homes. More worryingly, the civil war in Syria is spreading to nearby countries like Lebanon, Iraq, Yemen, and Pakistan. As they get drawn in further, thousands more will die and millions more will become refugees. We can't sit by and watch another Rwanda take place. Despite peace talks, there is no viable diplomatic solution. The dictator, Assad, won't leave because Russia and Iran are backing him. The now weakened Syrian rebels won't want to give up hope. And even if they did melt away, Al-Qaeda groups simply won't disappear. I'm not saying the UK and USA act alone. We can work with NATO, the Arab League, and other countries in the region. But if Iraq was a powerful argument against intervention, Syria will become a symbol of the danger of sitting on our hands. Intervention is not a matter of if, but when. If we wait, the cost in human lives is likely to be much, much higher.